registered homeschool called the Sandcastle Day School. The supposed principal, David Turpin, the father, but inside it was a nightmare for the children supposedly attending any kind of class there.
This whole situation is bringing attention to California's lack of homeschooling regulation. NBC7 Investigates reporter Mari Payton tells us more about whether those regulations possibly what the efforts could be done to perhaps change them, Mari, in the future.
Well, Mark Catherine, according to the Department of Education school directory, Turpin was running the Sandcastle Day School out of his Paris home since 2011. The State Department of Education registered the alleged school, but had never been inside. No one from law enforcement or any agency ever visited the Turpin residence.
Again, we had no call history at that residence to indicate that this type of activity was occurring there.
Authorities say if the Turpin children had been in public school, seen teachers or counselors, someone may have noticed their physical condition and told police, but instead they were hidden by a state-approved homeschool. In California, you can open a private school by simply filling out this online affidavit. David Turpin would have been required to give basic information, such as address and type of school, but nothing about the curriculum or children attending. There are more than 3,000 private schools registered with the California Department of Education. A spokesperson from the state agency stated they, quote, do not approve, monitor, inspect, or oversee private schools. In fact, no one is legally responsible for doing so in California. According to the Coalition for Responsible Home Education, a nonprofit that's for more oversight of homeschooled children, California is one of 15 states that ask parents only to register to start a homeschool. Now lawmakers say the system needs to change. Assemblyman Jose Medina represents parents. He says in the next 2 weeks, he will propose legislation for more oversight when it comes to homeschools.
We would designate some government authority to have that, the power to physically visit the sites. We look at restaurants and we make sure that restaurants that serve food to the public, their food that they provide is healthy and that the environment where the food is prepared is clean. And if we can do that for restaurants, I think that we can do that for schools.
A spokesperson from the Department of Education told me they will gladly work with legislatures to, quote, consider ways to change the law so we can prevent this type of tragedy. It is unknown whether these proposed in-person inspections would be done at the local or the state level at this point.
This is a call for an uprising. Welcome to today's show. As most of you probably saw, I did a video a few days ago about the 13 children who were supposedly slaves, who were tormented, trapped in their home by their Christian parents. I talked about how this story was likely fabricated in fake news to push an agenda. That agenda being one, homeschooling, right? Because the story is that they homeschooled their kids. They were strict on making them read the Bible. Almost, you know, the grandparents were coming, they were making them memorize the Bible, right? And you can read between the lines if you have discernment, if you have sense, and you realize that there's always an underlining theme and agenda of these stories. Now, YouTube pulled the video. They blocked it and pulled it. Nothing controversial was said. All I did was point out that those were the agendas that I saw there. I didn't buy the initial story because it didn't seem like it was real. You can look at the parents because they fit the stereotype of what child abusers are supposed to look like. White trash, right? The guy has a mullet, bull mullet cut, for crying out loud. Now you're seeing the aftermath of what happened. You're seeing article after article. Look at this. This won't be the first time or the last. The Turpins won't be the last. The Turpin child abuse story fits a widespread and disturbing homeschooling pattern. California abuse case sparks call for homeschooling oversight. That is the narrative. That is the theme. And that's why this story was put out there. If you look at the neighborhood, the homes are almost on top of one another. It would be nearly impossible for somebody not to be suspicious of these people doing this for 20 plus years. Okay, they had just taken the kids to Las Vegas. I think they might have run away if something was wrong. Some of the kids are in their 20s. There's always agendas behind this stuff. And remember, they always want Christians to look like the crazy ones, and they add homeschooling into that because that is a huge, huge problem for the elites. More and more people are homeschooling their kids. They're realizing that they're being taught nothing that is useful in this world, in the school system. Nothing but propaganda about fake history, bogus science. They're giving them a fake viewpoint of the world. So people are homeschooling. This is a dangerous thing for them. Because remember, the importance of the feminist movement and women's rights, for them, it's not about giving women rights. And it's not just about division. It's about breaking up the home. So the child is essentially ruled by the school. It's raised by the school. That's who it's disciplined by. That's where it learns this stuff. And what is not in the schools, what is removed from schools? God. And that's the common theme. And what they want to do with these younger generations, they want to raise them in a godless world in their mind. To block God, to block the Bible, to say that that's all bigots and hateful stuff, and you should be indoctrinated with all this other sense of false hope and lies. All the stuff you see going on in the news, the Me Too, nothing but lies. It's nothing but fake news to push across an agenda. That's why all of these women come out at the same time. Are the stories 20 years ago, 30 years ago, 40 years ago? They're just all coming out together, right? Everybody's just got the courage all of a sudden. They all happen to be rich, famous people who are a part of these bloodlines. These people inbreed with each other, okay? Some of the Hollywood celebrities you see married to each other, obviously, as most of you know, some of the women are actually men and vice versa. But for the most part, a lot of these people are also related to one another. That's why Hollywood celebrities date. It's like royal bloodlines, right? We've all heard of kings and queens and dating their daughters and all sorts of disturbing stuff. It still goes on. It's just hidden. They change their last name and all that stuff. So look at this theme now, because homeschooling for them is the worst thing. It's one of, at least, I should say, the worst things that could happen. Because what happens is the child who is homeschooled learns more about the world. That child is likely being raised by Christian parents, because in most cases they are Christian parents who are homeschooled. And they're raising them on what? On scripture. So after the Paris nightmare, it's time to monitor homeschools more closely, according to the LA Times. And listen, all the mainstream outlets are pumping this today, just like I said they would. Every once in a while, a horrible story involving homeschooled children grabs the public's attention. I mean, I'm sorry, can you give me a few? Oh, you mean some fabricated story about grabbing the public's attention? Most recently, a Paris couple allegedly kept their 13 sons and daughters chained and malnourished while filing the proper paperwork each year to tell the state that they were running a small home-based private school for the kids. So there's your narrative. Most tales of homeschooling are, of course, nothing like this. But the Paris case serves as a reminder that California plays too loosey-goosey when it comes to the welfare and education of homeschooled children. Now, you'll remember in that video, which, if you haven't seen it, it's actually up on The Fire Rises, my backup channel. It got taken off this one. I put it up over there for whatever reason. Hasn't gotten flagged. And, I mean, I'm sure it's been flagged. You know, it's just bizarre how YouTube's algorithm works. Maybe because I named it differently, I don't know. But it's still there right now. No knows how long it'll be there. But if you haven't seen it, go check it out. It's on my Fire Rises channel. It's the most recent video that was uploaded over there. So they're scaring people out there into thinking that people who homeschool are weirdos, just like people who don't get their kids vaccinated are weirdos, right? That's why you see celebrities out there talking and pushing vaccination. Oh, these parents who don't get their kids vaccinated are bad parents. They're abusive parents. That's what they say, right? The same thing with parents who don't allow their child to pick what gender they are at 3 years old. Oh, they're bad parents. It's abuse if they don't let the kid pick. It's insanity is what it is. It says, not that lawmakers should go all nanny state on parents who choose to educate their own children. New York State, for example, takes it too far by requiring homeschool students to take the state's annual standardized tests. Similarly, a court ruled 10 years ago that California homeschoolers must have a teaching credential. That ruling was quickly reversed after an outcry from homeschooling supporters. So what does that tell you? People were outcried about it, they pushed back, and they had to stop. Now they're going to come out with more fake news stories like this. Just like the stories for gun grabs, just like the stories for feminism, just like the stories for racism, just like the story of the incompetent cops to push martial law. It's the same thing. They don't want children being homeschooled. And they're going to push this narrative as hard as they can. And there's going to be more false flag things where they're going to come out and they're going to go, you know what? It's not fair to the kids. These parents are abusive. They're taking away college from the kid and a chance at a good future. That's all the crap that they're going to spew. And this is all about control, because this is a system of control. Indoctrination, control through repetition, to control the masses into believing in nothing but lies. And that's why they walk around like zombies. It says some parents choose homeschooling because they believe that in regular public schools, important educational priorities have been subordinated to standardized test scores. In fact, the reasons for homeschooling run the gauntlet: a desire for more religious instruction or an educational enriched with hands-on experiences, frequent family moves that would disrupt education, a child's serious medical issues, resistance to having children vaccinated. See, some of these reasons are laudable, others less so. But in the end, California's easygoing rules of homeschools, which mandate only that the schools provide very limited information to the state, make a wide variety of educational experiences possible. Now, we're seeing this stuff ramped up beyond belief right now in 2018. I mean, with all the agendas, I've never, you know, personally, as long as I've been awake, I've never seen so many things going on at once as far as agendas that they want pushed across. I've never seen this many. I've never seen so many people on board with it. I've never seen such a limited amount of pushback from citizens, even regards to free speech, right? It's like people are like, oh, shut down my channel and stuff like that, and others shouldn't be allowed to do this stuff, right? Just because we have opposite opinions. It's like, well, what about when you have an opinion on something and someone thinks it's controversial? Oh, no, that's not going to happen. It's like people don't even care about free speech anymore, which is one of the things that everybody should believe in. Because once they remove free speech, what do you have left? You can't even have an opinion that's different from somebody else's. But this right now, this is huge. This homeschooling thing is going to take off. I'm telling you, there's going to be more stories that come out. Only this time, the stories that come out, they're going to be way worse. They're going to have, you know, the children were raped, the children were killed, there's dead bodies, all sorts of stuff. And of course, remember, the characters involved will likely be Christian parents, because that's part of the narrative to get people to, you know, like I said in the video, when people saw that story about this Lake Paris family, okay, you might look at a service and go, oh, that's horrible, 13 people. But the underlining theme was that they were Christian homeschoolers. So when people hear of Christian, if they heard their, you know, somebody up the road, oh, they homeschool their kid and they're Christian, they're instantly, their brain, because this is how the brain works, it's going to tag the two things together like a computer. And it's going to go, oh, I wonder if the kids there are safe. I wonder if they're weirdos like that other family. That's how mind control works. So these articles are just going on and on about the dangers of homeschooling. And they're telling you flat out, it's not going to be the last. Right? It says the Turpins are shocking, but they are not without precedent. All families, of course, can mask horror underneath, but the Turpins' horror was likely kept hidden by a very specific tool. We know now that the parents homeschooled their children under that's all you need to know, under the fake name of Sandcastle Day School, which is simply the name they used when they filed a private school affidavit with the state of California. Understanding how the Turpins got away with what they did for so long is also partly a matter of understanding homeschooling law. The fact that there's homeschooling law should be another one of those things, I know I always say it, enough to wake someone up, right? What's the problem if you want to homeschool your child? Because the zombie out there, their mindset would be, oh, homeschool. Oh, okay. So they don't want their kid to go to college. He's not going to have a good job. Oh, okay. Right? But why is the government then? Why are they so obsessed with it? Why do you have to have these laws? Why do you have to fill out all this paperwork? Why do you have to follow regulations for homeschooling? Think about it, right? 100 years ago, didn't it make it? I mean, you know, kids at 5 years old were running farms, 10 years old, taking care of their families, learning how to take care of themselves, live off the land. You kidding me? Those people, you know, not only do they have it better then, because they did, but the children at 10 years old were smarter than people now who are 30, 40, 50 years old in today's society. Everyone's an idiot because all they learn is nothing but crap and lies. And they're all what? Narcissistic, egotistical, prideful. It's all about how you look, what you wear. I mean, look at this. And people don't see it. So again, I'm not going to keep going through the article, but there's a bunch of articles out there today that came out. Fox News, LA Times, New Republic. You name the outlet, they talked about it, and they said, we need to relook into homeschooling. Boom. And this is how it works. This is why this stuff happens. Why you need to be able to spot these types of stories, because you've got to look under the surface and see what's the narrative that they're pushing. Because when you see the narrative they're pushing, you could point it out. You could make sure you don't fall into the trap, or others around you don't fall into the trap of believing this stuff. Because this is how they get people to willingly go along with giving up their rights and joining into this absolute cancer that is the New World Order. I thank you for listening to today's show. God bless all of you and your families.